What's up, YouTube? Out here in this half-ass rain, you know when it's kind of shitty raining, but it's not actually raining, so it just puts shit on your face shield and stuff, and you can't really get it off because it's not beating up. That kind of shit, yeah, I'm dealing with that right now. But I digress. Oh, the street's closed. Navy life. It's one that has had a pretty big effect on my command recently, so I just wanted to shoot it out to let you guys know, some of you up-and-coming seamans and whatever else you might be going into, and you guys who already are serving or have served, you know all about this, I'm sure. I'm sure it affects all branches. And that is the knee-jerk reaction. It's a horrible plague. There's actually a different saying for it in the Navy. It's one crew, one screw. And I'll give you some examples of it. Well, I'll explain what it is, then I'll give you examples of it. So what it basically means is if one person fucks up, one person, one, out of however much your command is, mine's like 160, carriers get up into the thousands, and so on and so forth. But if one person fucks up in your command, hey, then everybody, oh, fuck that noise, tell me not to turn left. Bitch, watch me turn left anyway. Rules of the road don't apply to me. But if one person screws up, then everyone gets punished equally. Equally. Instead of, you know, because you're going to hear it. Everybody's like, why the fuck don't you just punish that guy? Nope. Did you just try to apply logic in the military? Not happening. So yeah, one crew, one screw. Get used to that idea if you're joining. I sound really bitter right now. It's because I am. It's because fuck that bullshit. So here's a few examples of that. So back when I was in sub school, or A school, I was just leaving, what was that class called? It was a class where they teach you about Linux and shit for people who didn't know about Linux and servers and all this bullshit. I basically slept through it because I like aced the shit out of that course. But it was a course about that. I forgot the name. And what happened was when I was leaving, like the day I left, some guy drew a big old dragon cock. You'll learn about those in the Navy. I don't know if they're in other branches, but a dragon cock, which is literally what it sounds like, in one of the heads, and he drew on the tip of it, the tip of the dick was the head of the LPO of Radio A School. They just basically called him a dickhead. So, knee-jerk reaction. Everybody in that whole class, all of radio, everybody on the floor, my class would have been included had we not graduated, all got their Liberty cards revoked back to white card, which essentially means you cannot leave base. It's basically saying that. And we, everybody, not we all, because I got the fuck out of there. I'm just trying to keep moving. And they all went back to white card because of that one thing, that one time, that one person, who they did find out, did. Some bullshit. Or in the case of my command, we had a GMT, General Military Training, that was at 0700, right? So the normal time to come in is 0730. And this GMT was on a Monday, and everybody left on Friday not knowing about it. The only reason I knew about it was because I heard somebody complaining about it. I'm not going to say who or anything, but I heard somebody complain to somebody else about it. And they were like, oh yeah, you're screwed. You got to go to that. You're screwed. And that's how I learned about it. So I was on time, and most of my division was on time, but like 8 guys out of 160 weren't on time. So what happened? The liberty for everybody now expires every day, 0700, because of that. That fucking knee-jerk reaction. Instead of punishing the people that fucked up, everybody now gets punished. And, like, yeah, it's not bitter. It doesn't really, take control of your whole military career. Like, you're not gonna fucking end hero because of this, but it's really annoying, and it's just something you gotta put up with. It's one of the drawbacks that you just gotta like suck it up and deal with kind of bullshit. And yeah, like I said, those aren't the only fucking incidents in like this last month that the command has been affected by with these knee-jerk reactions. I just wanted, you know, like to get a video out, let you new guys know about that bullshit, because it is bullshit. It's one of the things that I actually hate, along with the bureaucracy, but then we'll save that for another video.
Yeah.
So yeah, guys, that's your Navy life for this week. It comes a little late in the week because of the rain, and I have fucking duty started again, so now I got duty days where I miss entire fucking days. And it's just, you know, that military life catching up to me. It's all good, guys. So hopefully everybody's running safe. Thank you very much for viewing. Stay tuned. Please leave me a comment, a like, subscribe, you know, if you want to. Or if you're one of those new guys I was talking about, there's at least three of you now watching that are in depth. Go ahead and ask any specific questions that you might be scared about going into boot camp or actually finally, you know, joining our little club of hell and whatnot and boats and being seamen on boats together and all the seamen's get together and it's like a bukkake. You know what I'm talking about, guys? Nah, they got weird real fast. Guys, thank you for watching. See y'all later.